Hey there, and welcome inside the labyrinth. I am Tiffany Appen, and it is starting to feel like fall, finally. I am so excited, busting out the shawls, the cloaks, the warmer 18th century clothes, the mitts, all that fun stuff. And today, I'm doing a little bonus episode for you guys. It is soap making day at the Neville House, and it's gonna be fun. So hope you enjoy it, and we'll show you how to make some soap.
Water in another vessel.
Yeah.
Then boil that down, right? And then
we have to try to get the oil out of it. Rosemary.
The diluted one.
What do you have? What kind
What kind of soap are you making today?
It's called Shepherd's Pride.
Oh, okay.
It's one that I like the best, I guess. It has lemon.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's, we selected lavender as a scent.
Oh, well, you can't go wrong with lavender. Yeah.
All right, and I'm not really sure how to go about all of this. Mm-hmm. I've never done a demonstration before.
Oh, okay.
So I thought I would get them all measured so mm-hmm. that I'm not just taking time to measure.
Yeah. So this is your first presentation?
It's the first time I've done a demonstration.
Oh, okay. Cool.
I've made lots of soap.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Sold lots.
Mm-hmm.
Always did it in my own kitchen.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure it'll be enjoyable. Can't wait till this is all fall colors here and the leaves are turning. It looks so pretty. And there's her soap.
Heat it all up. If you're using milk, you have to keep the milk cool because it has fat in it. And the lye plus fat equals soap. So if you let this get too hot, it will spongify before you ever get the rest of your oils in it. So, I've got ice in here, keep it cool, I'm going to put the milk in. I've already, we milk the goats, strain them out, I pasteurize it on the stove in the house, and I measure it out into the amount I need for bench soap, put it in containers and freeze it. When I use it, I don't want it totally thawed. I want there to be chunks in it, which there are. So put this in here. And splatter it. Isn't that a pretty container?
So colonial.
Okay. And then I'm gonna start adding lye. I didn't measure. Nope.
What exactly is lye, anyway?
Hydrogen, sodium hydroxide.
I mean, where does it come from? Like, what substance is it? Like, powdery something from a plant?
No. I can't tell you where this comes from. I absolutely don't know. When they used to make it, It was wood ashes
oh.
that were processed some way with, been set the barrel under the eaves where it would get rainwater.
Hmm.
And somehow or another, that in that process, that's got something for these historians to research for you. Because I don't know how that worked, and I don't want to do it. Okay, I didn't measure this first because it's kind of involved with substance.
In that era, was it more common to use milk or water?
Water.
It was more common.
There was even a time span that I read about, and I should have researched it more, that they were selling, like colonists were selling lye water back to England. Now, why? I don't know, but they do. And that was kind of before the soap industry took off. Okay, so we're going to add, what I've got in here is the shortening, 3 pounds of shortening. I'm going to add the olive oil to it. And I've actually mixed the safflower oil and the canola. And the lanolin. This is not the way I usually get it.
I'm waiting for it to come back here and hit me. Time.
So you could scoop it out, but I couldn't find it.
You don't have your safety belts on, so I would flip that down.
Lanolin comes from sheep, from the wool.
Do you actually use the soap that you made?
I do, all the time. I sell a lot of it. Use a lot. That's the only soap I use anymore, actually.
Now, is it usually with water or milk that you?
Milk. Goat's milk. I
like
goats. I've heard goats.
Oh, okay. It does not lather, right?
Some does.
Really?
Depends on what you put in it for additives.
Oh, okay.
Some doesn't, but some does. This should somewhat, the lanolin helps. Helps it to lather a little. Okay. And it has to age for 6 weeks before you can use it.
Oh.
Or the lye would still be capable of reusing.
That is interesting.
But after that, it'll last forever. When we got a farm ready to have a sale, we found some up in the attic that had been there who knows how long. Nobody knows how long. And it was still good.
What scent do you put in there?
This is going to be lavender.
Oh, that's nice.
And how do you determine that in lavender? How do you determine it's going to be lavender?
Because that's what I purchased. I don't make sense.
Okay, no, but lavender doesn't like take to it better than any other scent. It's just a scent.
It's just
a good scent.
I actually tried raisins. It's doable, but I didn't have time to give some care, let it beat it and get it dry, all the stuff you have to do. It'll come down. I'll just keep stirring it, and if you can get some of that stirred down in it, it'll give it a little start to feel like it has some drips here. But
do you ever make just solid lye soap?
I guess I'm not sure what you mean.
Well, when you smell it, you can smell the lye in. It's more for like laundry detergent.
I have made it that I did not put any scent in. It didn't really smell like lye, though. It just smelled like soap. And then you grate it up and mix it with... seems like it was borax and I don't remember what else.
Then that's more for clothes.
Yeah, for
laundry.
It doesn't suds though. I didn't find that it suds at all. I'm done with that too. You can smell the lye in this now. And you would think that stirring a chemical like that into milk that you would totally destroy it. Can you see that? It just looks kind of like thin pudding. through. That one is older than the hills, still works fine. The ones you buy today, nah. They'll last a little while when they're done. Fragrance you actually don't add to the very last thing. I don't think it has the strength to withstand. Lye's pretty strong stuff, so you just don't add it. There is a little dab of sugar. I don't know.
It's falling.
Yeah, I was going to say maybe it's the
there is a little dab of aloe vera. Mm-hmm. And I have all of these ingredients. I weigh them out on that little scale there because it's all done in ounces. This needs to process for 1 minute. Wasted a thing in about $3. So, cheese doesn't get it for me. Okay, we're ready?
Ready?
the spoon?
Not sure you'd like the results of that.
It's like washing your mouth off with soap, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, but you might not have a tongue left.
That'd be a familiar flavor.
Yeah, but the lie in that is it takes 6 weeks to cure, so.
Maybe that'll stop him from saying bad things.
No. If I haven't stopped by now.
You see a lot of people who killed themselves taking lye.
Oh, yeah.
And it is not a fast death. And
nope.
It is not a pleasant death.
Why would they take lye?
Really?
It eats holes right in your stomach.
Wow.
Because once it hits your stomach, it comes back up and burns again. So you just put your throat down.
You need to bleed internally.
Yeah, it takes about 25 or 30 minutes to kill you.
So in other words, do not eat lye.
Yeah, I wouldn't be that and rat no more.
I would much rather do hemlock.
Rat poison.
Mm-hmm. And hemlock is not the tree, folks. Hemlock grows about wild. You've probably seen it and smelled it.
Yeah, it's still painful too, though.
Yeah.
What do? Make a tea out of it?
Yeah.
Does it have a useful purpose and it's abused, or what is it?
What, hemlock? Yeah. Ask Socrates.
He killed himself with it, but is there a use for it?
No.
No. I think that's the question.
Does it look like a pine tree?
No.
Forces the lye content and fats together.
Secret incantations, I will. Double, double toil with trouble, fire burn and cauldron bubble.
All right.
And now we end up with seven.
Where's your black hat?
It's in the car, Dan.
It's never without it.
Oh, yes.
Set it up on top of my piano, and it just sits there for 6 weeks.
Thank you.